Well, police say Butler was behind the wheel and he was going anywhere between 60 to 90 miles per hour. Here on Ventura Boulevard, there's a curve and he was going much faster than the 30 mile per hour speed limit that's posted. Today, friends and family are gathering at the crash site saying that they are still in disbelief over his death and his wife's death. Flowers, candles, notes, and stuffed animals left at the crash site by close friends of former NBA player Rasual Butler and his wife, American Idol contestant Leah LaBelle.
We are going to miss two great people. They were great. I don't care what anybody says, yo, and I don't want anybody to try to trump something what it is, because no, these were two great individuals, and it hurts that they're gone.
The two were killed in a violent crash early Wednesday morning. Butler was behind the wheel of a dark-colored Range Rover when the vehicle veered off Ventura Boulevard in Studio City, hitting a parking meter and tumbling several times. Police say Butler was going double, possibly triple, the speed limit. It's not clear if drugs or alcohol played a role, but friends say Butler and LaBelle didn't live that type of lifestyle.
They're not partiers, they're not rebel rousers, they're not not anything that you would expect something like this. This is the last couple you would think.
Rasual played for the NBA from 2002 to 2015 for a number of teams, including the Los Angeles Clippers. Tracy Murray, a former NBA player and analyst on ABC7's Slam Dunk sports show, knew Butler.
He was always one of those guys that worked real hard and he was a joy to be around. He was always one of your more honest and real people that I've met.
On social media, tributes are pouring in. Former Clippers player Paul Pierce tweeted, "So sad this morning to hear about my friend and teammate. Rest in peace, Rasual Butler. Appreciate people around you because you never know." Now, Butler and LaBelle were at Penn's Bowling Alley in Studio City last night. The manager there say that they were regulars at that bowling alley and confirmed that they left around 1 o'clock this morning. It's not clear where Butler and LaBelle were between 1 a.m. and 2:30 when the crash occurred.